What's up? This is Patrick.
Tzvia.
From Guy in the Cube. And in this video, Tzvia and I are going to show you how you could be a data scientist without actually being a data scientist. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy, Tzvia. The first video was so popular that we had to have you back to talk more about Azure Data Explorer. Now, you're gonna teach me how to be a data scientist. Is that true?
By end of this session, you will have the capabilities not only to be a data scientist, but also to be a fortune teller.
Okay, a fortune teller. All right. So the only two people that I know that can predict the future are data scientists and fortune teller. And you're telling me by the end of this very short video, I'm going to be able to predict the future with Azure Data Explorer.
Let's try and see. This is one thing that I promise it to you.
All right. So you guys know how we like to do a Guy in the Cube. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to Tzvia's laptop.
In this demo, I will connect to the sales activities of Windows in 2016. You can see here that I have a data set that presents the time and also the version of the operation system and the country. Now I'm using a built-in function of make series that take all the data that I have, fill the gaps, and present it over the timeline with the resolution of 1 hour activity.
So wait a minute, what's this built-in function? What do you mean? So there's just like machine learning functions built into Data Explorer?
Exactly. We build in time series capabilities as part of the service, which allow you just provide the data and the service itself do all the magic without you involving the system. So it's great for people that want to understand the data without being a data scientist.
Okay, I gotta see more.
After I have the time series for the different operation system, I want to see anomalies of my sales activity for Windows 10. I have a predefined function of anomalies that I can provide the sensitivity of the anomalies. Oh. I can run this activity, query, and now on top of my time series, I can see those red dots that present anomalies with my sales activity.
Wow!
I can easily change the sensitivity up and down and see more. And without being a data scientist, I can understand my sales activities and explore more what I did very good over here and what should I do to improve my activities over there.
Wow.
So you have any sales data, for example, any activities that is over time, you can use the time series to build and to see the patterns of your information. And then you can run anomalies function and find the hidden secret inside your data.
But all I need to do is know the functions, right? I bring my data and know the functions and I can start doing these things. I can become a data scientist.
Exactly. Just stream the data into Gusto.
I don't feel like I'm a fortune teller yet. I don't feel like I'm predicting the future yet.
Okay, so for that, I have the next one. So I have the sales activity of the past 4 weeks, but I want to predict what will be my sales numbers next week. I have another built-in function, which called forecast. For this one, I need to send also the information of the sales activity that I had. I run it, and in a couple of seconds, the prediction of what is coming in the next period. The orange schema is the data that I have, and the blue one is the data that I predict. What do you feel about that, Patrick?
At that drop-off point, that's where the actual data that I have ends, and then from that point, that's where all the predictions happen. And all I'm doing is using the built-in forecast function, bringing my own data, and now I'm predicting the future. Wow.
Do you think that you are capable to run those functions?
I am absolutely capable. I just need to spend a little time familiarizing myself with the inputs for the functions, but now I'm a data scientist. Boom, just like that.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, Tzvia, for coming back. And what I'm going to do is I'll get a link to the documentation for the functions posted in the comments below. If you haven't watched the video that Tzvia and I did on the introduction to Azure Data Explorer, you should go check that video out. Tzvia, thank you so much for coming hang out with us. Guys, if you have any questions, comments, you know, about this, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, you know, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam,
Tzvia,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.